And so I would like to welcome all of you to our science demonstration this morning entitled Actions Speak Louder Than Words. Now, the first slide, number 2, is a picture of Martin Luther King Jr. And he led a great group of people. He had a nice use of the English language, and people listened to him. But like I said, even though we speak with the tongues of men and of angels, next slide is a picture of President Obama accepting the nomination as to run for the presidency of the United States. All those people in this picture have gathered around to listen to what he has to say. Next slide. Without charity, however, we're on slide 4, we are as sounding brass, and some brass can sound very nice, but it doesn't last, and I'll tell you about that in a minute. Or slide 5, as a tinkling cymbal, and this is a huge cymbal. Without love, that's what our words are like. Now, slide 6. We'll talk a little bit about music today. All music causes vibrations, such as the music that's produced on this harp. The strings are vibrating. Next slide. With brass, it's the same way. The sounds that they produce through their instrument vibrate through the air, sound waves, and reach our ears. Same with strings on slide 8. Same with percussion. Did you know a piano is really a percussive instrument, even though it has strings? Because it's pounding, or the strings. Now, there's an instrument in slide 10 that's called the sheng, S-H-E-N-G. This is an ancient Chinese instrument. It dates back thousands of years, and it's made up of these tubes that a person blows in. Now, for our science demonstration today, the only thing you need is a plastic spoon, a rubber band, and I said a 2-foot length of twine. It doesn't have to be that long, but let me show you what I have. I have 2 different size spoons. Here's this size, and here's this size. And what I'm going to show you is that when we whirl this around, we can get this rubber band to start vibrating and make a sound. And at home, you can try this. You can try it with different size spoons. You can try it with different size rubber bands. But onto this rubber band, I've tied a piece of string. So that's what's hanging. And then I loop the rubber band around the spoon lengthwise. Now we're going to go and step. We'll have to step out to some open air. Or maybe we can do it right here. Let me give it a try. I think we should, okay. Now, I'm going to whirl this around. And let's see what happens. Can you hear the sound? It's not just the air. There! The faster you do it, you want to give it a try, Ashley?
Not here. I'll hit something.
No, you won't hit something. So you stand like I'm doing, and you whirl it around. Now, it's not just something moving through the air that you might sense. The rubber band itself starts to vibrate. Okay, so we're going to give it another try and see if you can tell when the rubber band has started to vibrate. Wait a minute. Now, okay, now you wrap the extra string around your hand and then just give it a whirl and see what happens, Ashley. Faster, faster, faster. Don't give up. Keep going. Keep going. We'll have to send her outside later today, not during Sabbath school or church, of course. Okay, that's simple. A simple little illustration to show you something about sound. Now, the reason I'm telling you this is, once you hear the sound, it's gone. It doesn't linger around. Once the note is plucked, you hear it and it's gone, unless you're on the piano and you're holding a pedal that sustains that. And Paul is saying that we're like sounds without love. And those sounds, they don't go on forever unless you keep repeating it and keep singing it or making that noise. It's transient and temporary. God is saying in 1 Corinthians 13 that speech, knowledge, faith, good works, etc. are nothing compared to charity. Speech lasts only for the moment of the sound that it produces. Knowledge can become outdated. Belief or faith is good, but without action or love, it's nothing. And our works, whether we're feeding the poor, even giving our bodies to be burned, they profit us nothing. That's what Paul is telling us here in 1 Corinthians. If we read through 1 Corinthians 13, we read, though we speak with the tongues of angels, though we have the gift of prophecy, understand all mysteries and all knowledge, have all faith to remove mountains, if we don't have charity, we have nothing. And then if I bestow all my goods to the poor, though that's works, if I do all these wonderful works but have not charity, it profits us nothing. And then Paul gives us this list of what charity does. Can you think of one, Ashley?
It faileth not.
It never fails, that's right. And so if your mother at 3 a.m. in the morning, and like little clever queen, your child is ill, you're up with your child to help. If you're a father, you're doing the same thing. It never fails. It bears all things, hopes all things, endures all things. So there we have. The purpose of the illustration is to show what sound is and how it's a result of vibration of sound waves through the air. But it has an end, at least in our world. Once the sound is produced, it's there. It's there for the moment and it's over. But love never fails. It never ends. And even though it seems like it's being poured out on a useless subject, so to speak, on someone who doesn't return your love, someone who's harsh and mean and bad and a criminal or whatever, love never fails. And it hasn't been lost anywhere. If nothing else, the love that you give to others that may be rejected and renounced and trampled upon, that love will return to our Heavenly Father because He's the source of it. It never, never is lost. Love isn't. Sounds are, although I have to tell you that a record of the sounds we make, whether the music we make or the words we say or whatever, that's all recorded. And I don't know what eternity is like or what heaven is like. I can't say anything about sound there. But here, when I say hello, there's nothing after that. The sound is gone after I finish speaking. But love continues on. Love is never lost. It never fails and it never ends, at least God's. I want to thank you for joining us in our little science demonstration. And until we meet again, may God bless you and keep you. Bye for now.